Education Minister Stephen Lecce. Thank you for joining us, Minister.
Thank you.
Just days ago, you said you were confident in Monday's returns. Surely the upward trend was already known at that point. So why the abrupt about-face?
Well, in fact, it wasn't known. It only became known yesterday by the Chief Medical Officer of Health, gave us data for the first time yesterday afternoon that suggested that an analysis of the Christmas break between Christmas, essentially New Year's, there's a 117% spike in youth-related cases. That was known to us yesterday and today and before you, confirming, based on the best medical advice, that schools remain online for the next 2 weeks, recognizing it is a difficult impact on parents and on kids, but we will not at any point sacrifice the progress we've made in keeping schools open, and nor will we compromise the safety of families in this province.
Earlier this afternoon, Dr. Williams said the extra 2 weeks will give the province time to add further steps and protections in schools. What exactly are those steps?
Yeah, I mean, 8 in 10 schools in Ontario, the day that schools closed before the holidays, had no cases of COVID at all. We're doing something right in this province, and we should really remind ourselves of the safety of schools. I mean, they've been an incredible effort to keep them safe. With that said, we have always systematically stepped up our protocol to ensure we reduce risk, especially as COVID increases within our community. We'll be announcing and unveiling a plan to expand asymptomatic testing province-wide. We'll be allocating an additional $380 million for priorities like air ventilation, PPE, more staffing, more cleaning, as well as we'll be getting about $700 million of projects announced and completed this calendar year for things, again, like air ventilation. Altogether, this should help really reduce risk. And as I say, our priority is to get these kids back. We know how important it is for parents and for the children themselves.
Mm-hmm. Now, this isn't the first lockdown. It might not be the last. What is the province's long-term plan should we see another spike in cases?
Well, obviously, the increase in vaccinations, the fact that in the highest risk regions by the 21st of January, all long-term care residents and frontline staff will get vaccinated. That is a lifeline that I think is really going to help create promise and hope that we can reopen our schools in the medium term. In the short term, we're going to act on improving testing, on investments, on really making sure that this province continues to lead the country. We have had one of the most successful school reopenings. When, you know, when teacher unions and others didn't want us to open in September, we opened. We stayed open till Christmas. And because of, obviously, congregation over the holidays and spike of cases amongst young people, we're taking the difficult, but I think the necessary action to ensure the schools remain safe in this province and to get these kids back, knowing how important it is to their development and to their mental health.
Difficult, but necessary action. All right. Thank you so much, Minister. That's Education Minister Stephen Lecce.
Thank you.